Practical Mental Influence, William W. Atkinson. The Law of Vibration. Students of history find a continuous chain of reference to the mysterious influence of one human mind over that of others. In the earliest records, traditions and legends may be found reference to the general belief that it was possible for an individual to exert some weird, uncanny power over the minds of other persons, which would influence the latter for good or evil. And more than this, the student will find an accompanying belief that certain individuals are possessed of some mental power which bends even things and circumstances to its might. Way back in the dim past of man's history on this planet, this belief existed, and it has steadily persisted in spite of the strenuous opposition of material science, even unto the present day. The years have not affected the belief, and in these dawning days of the 20th century, it has taken on a new strength and vitality. For its adherents have boldly stepped to the front, and confronting the doubting materialistic thinkers, have claimed the name of science for this truth, and have insisted that it be taken, once and for all, from the category of superstition, credulity, and ignorant phantasm. Were it not pitiable, it would be amusing to glance at the presumptuous, complacent, smug, self-satisfied position of the materialistic school of thinkers, who would brush aside as a foolish delusion that which man of the wisest men of the past ages have accepted and taught as the truth. The modern know-it-alls would sneer contemptuously at facts that are known to be of actual occurrence in the daily lives of thousands of intelligent people, and which the experience of humankind has demonstrated for many centuries, in all lands and all races. The trouble lies in the dogmatic assumption of the materialistic school that what is known as mind, in merely some peculiar action of the material brain. Some writers, even holding that brain, secretes thought, just as the liver secretes bile. They refuse to see that the operation of mind is a manifestation of energy known as electricity, magnetism, light, heat, gravitation, cohesion, etc. Because mental energy does not register the vibrations of these lower forms of energy, they conclude that the higher mental energy does not exist. Having formulated a theory to suit their materialistic conceptions, they try to ignore all facts not consistent with their theory. If they find a fact that will not squeeze into their narrow theory well, so much the worse for the fact, as a writer has said, and they promptly ignore or dispute it. As a matter of truth, the investigator is not compelled to resort to metaphysical explanations to account for the phenomena of mental influence. The very facts of physical science itself, if rightly interpreted, will give the clue to the mystery, and will point the steps of the honest investigator toward the path where he may find the solution of the perplexing riddle. Although we know that the real solution lies in the metaphysical dream, still even physical science will corroborate the facts of its metaphysical sister science. And indeed, of contradicting the latter will actually go far toward furnishing analogous facts, principal basis for a theory of metaphysical facts. The student will see at once that so far as physical science is concerned, it must begin at the phenomenon of thought transference. For in that phase of the subject may be found an elementary principle in evidence in many other forms of phenomena. We have given many instances of thought transference in the two preceding volumes of this series, entitled Mind Reading and Psychomancy, respectively. And so we need not repeat the same in this place. The main fact is that thought transference does exist, and may be accounted upon purely scientific grounds, without calling in the truth of metaphysical thought. We know that this is a strong statement and a positive assertion, but we also know that the same may be demonstrated. Let us consider this phase of the subject. In the first place, physical science teaches that all underlying forms, degrees, and apparent differences in matter and energy, there is to be found a manifestation of some elementary energy, which manifests in what is known as vibrations. Everything in the material world is in vibration, ever manifesting a high degree of motion. Without vibration, there would be no such thing as a material universe. From the electronic corpuscles, which science teaches compose the atom, up through the atom and molecule, until most complex forms of matter are manifested, there is the ever-present vibration. And through all forms of energy, light, heat, electricity, magnetism, and the rest, vibration is also ever-present. In fact, physical science itself teaches that not only is vibration the basic force underlying other forces and the various forms of matter, but also that the apparent differences between the various forms of matter and also between the various forms of energy are caused simply and solely by the varying degrees of vibration manifested. Just as a difference between the lowest tone that can be distinguished by the ear of man and the highest note that can be distinguished by the same organ of sense is merely a difference between the rate of vibration, just as is the difference between the dull red colour at one end of the spectrum and the violet at the other end, with the intervening colours known as indigo, blue, green, yellow, and orange. With all the combinations of shades arising from them, just as the difference between the greatest degree of cold known to science and the greatest degree of heat that can be conceived of, just as these great differences due solely and wholly to varying rates of vibration, so is the difference between, and all forms of matter or force simply a matter of the rate of vibration. In short, all material and physical things are simply manifestations of some infinite and eternal energy from which all things proceed, their differences resulting merely from the different degree of vibration being manifested in them. Remember that this is not vague philosophy or airy metaphysics or spiritualistic vagaries, to quote from the materialistic writers, but facts claimed and admitted by the greatest physical scientists of the age, as a reference to their lectures and textbooks will prove to anyone. And, more than this, any intelligent physical scientist will tell you that science has every reason to believe that there are great fields of energy and force, the vibrations of which are far too high for even the most delicate instruments of science to record, but which nevertheless exist and manifest effects. It was only the other day that science was able to catch the X-rays and other forms of high radioactivity. And yet these rays and forces had always existed. And tomorrow, science will perfect instruments capable of registering still higher forms of energy. And by, some scientist will perfect an instrument capable of registering and recording the subtle vibrations of thought. And perhaps in time, someone will perfect the instrument so that it will not only record such thought vibrations and waves, but, like the phonograph, it will be able to reproduce and send forth similar vibrations so that others may feel the thoughts, just as they now hear the sounds from the phonograph. Such a prediction is no more wonderful than would have been the prediction of the telephone, the phonograph, the wireless telegraph, and sundry other discoveries and inventions 100 years ago. Did you ever think that there are colours that the eye cannot see, but which delicate instruments clearly register? In fact, the rays of light which sunburn the face, and which register on the photographic plate, are not visible to the eye. The eye sees the lower rays, but only instruments adapted for the purpose detect the higher ones. Your eye cannot see the x-ray as it passes through the room, but the plate will catch it, and its light may make a photograph. The rays of light visible to the eyes are only the lower ones. The higher ones are far beyond the power of the eye to record, and beyond even the range of the most delicate instrument, there exist rays and waves of light of such high vibratory rate as to defy even its power to record. Did you ever know that there are sounds unheard by human ears that the microphone will catch and magnify? Scientific imagination dreams of instruments that will catch the songs of the mite, like insects, and magnify them until they can be distinguished. There are waves of electricity that may pass through your body, unperceived by you, and yet powerful enough to run electric lights. Listen to the words of certain eminent scientists. Professor Alicia Gary, a celebrated scientist and teacher, has said, "There is much food for speculation in the thought that there exist sound waves that no human ear can hear, and colour waves of light that no eye can see. The long, dark, soundless space between 40,000 and 400 trillion vibrations per second, and the infinity of range beyond 700 trillion vibrations per second, where light ceases in the universe of motion, makes it possible to indulge in speculation." Professor Williams, the well-known scientific writer, has said, "There is no gradation between the most rapid undulations or trembling that produces our sensations of sound, and the slowest of those which give rise to our sensations of gentlest warmth. There is a huge gap between them, wide enough to include another world of motion, all lying between our world of sound and our world of heat and light. And there is no good reason whatever for supposing that matter is incapable of such intermediate activity, or that such activity may not give rise to intermediate sensations, provided that there are organs of taking up and sensitizing their movements. And so you see that in the scientific theory of vibrations, there may be found plenty of room for a scientific explanation of all that is claimed by the adherents of truth of mental influence, without getting out of the region of physical science, and without invading the plane of metaphysics. And there are many more proofs from the same source, which we may touch upon as we proceed. There is but one truth, and it manifests on all planes, the spiritual, the mental, and the physical. And manifestations agree and coincide. So no mentalist need fear the test of physical science, for each plane will bear out the facts and phenomena of the ones below or above it. The three are but varying phases of one. In this little work, we shall hug close to the plane of physical science, because by doing so, we will be able to make the subject much clearer to many than if we had attempted to express the teaching in metaphysical terms.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.